This tutorial, I'm going to introduce how to attack this vulnerable program. In this vulnerable program, we have the main function. The main function has a local buffer, which is FOO here, which is pretty large. And then at line 15, we have this problematic gets function. Gets will get user input, but it doesn't check the length of the buffer. Get will write whatever the user enters into this buffer. In this way, buffer overflow may happen. So here is our plan to attack this vulnerable program. So first, we need to find out the length of the malicious string. So to find out the length of the malicious string, we have to look at the stack frame of the main function. This is the stack frame of the main function. You can see here we have the local buffer, then we have something else, then we have the return address. So we are going to craft a malicious string which will overwrite everything including return address and also local buffer and other things. And so we need to first determine the length of the string, right? So to do this, this is what I did. I'm going to actually load the victim program into IDE freeware. Then by looking at the deassembly of the main function, I can find out the stack frame, right, like this one. So let's do it. So here is what I'm going to do. So first, let me start command prompt. Let me go to this folder. So I'm going to compile this code. Okay, good. So now we got this exe file. And now I start IDE freeware. And open this victim1.exe file. Okay, so here is our, deassembly of the main function. And so by just looking at the deassembly, you can actually craft this stack frame. And we can calculate the result is, so basically, you can see here, this FOO buffer is 1000 and 280 bytes. Now we have another 12 bytes here, right? So, and then we have the return address. Okay, so now we understand how we can overwrite the buffer. The next thing is that we need to determine the shell code address, because you can see here, so when we actually overwrite the return address, we need an address that will point to the shell code, which will be somewhere stored here. Okay. And so, for example, the shell code can start at the start of the local buffer, right? So we need to find out the address of the local buffer. How can we do that? Let's do this. So I'm going to debug the victim1.exe and we will find out where the local buffer is on the stack. So you can see here, the main function will be put into memory address 00401550. C0. And so now I'm going to start a immunity debugger. load victim1.exe. So I need to find out the entry address here. What is the entry address? I forgot. So 401560. 1560. Okay. 1560 here. It's here. Okay, so I already set a breakpoint here. So we can just actually run the program. It will stop here. Right. So then I'm going to perform step over until I reach get. So at this point, I need to enter something within, you know, this command console, returned. Good. So basically, get receives the user input and writes the user input into the local buffer. The local buffer is on the stack. So now we find the sequence of A's. You can see it's here. So now we know, basically, you know, here is the address of the local buffer foo here. Okay, so let me copy the address here. Copy to clipboard. Good. So we know this is the address of a local buffer. Okay, so now let's look at our step three. So here is my plan. So my plan is that I'm going to craft the shell code. Okay, so my shell code starts with 1690. 90 means doing nothing. It is an instruction, which means doing nothing. Then my actual shell code is 112 bytes. And following the actual shell code, now we have 1,164 nine zeros. Okay, so basically this part is 1,292 bytes, which will be used to override this part of the stack. Then the last 3 bytes is the partial address of the shell code, so which is the address of a local buffer. This one. So you can see the first byte of the address is a 0. 0 cannot be included into a string. So that's why we only keep the three least significant bytes of the address. Okay, so now you can see basically our malicious string will overwrite this part, and this part will be our shell code, including all the nine zeros. Then the last 3 bytes will overwrite the return address. So in this case, basically the return address is changes to the address of the local buffer. So the address of local buffer is this one, right? So that's our plan. Okay, so finally we will perform the attack. I'm going to use Python to perform the attack. Okay, so here is our command, and I have to change the last 3 bytes. So this will be 61F9D0. So pay attention to the order here, And we are using Little India, right? So the least significant byte should show up first. So this is the least significant byte. Okay, and so this is should be good. Okay, so now we have everything, and we're going to perform the attack. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to paste the command to here. You can see, right? So Python is going to actually run this script, and output will be injected into this victim1.exe through the pipe. Okay, so our shell code is benign. We'll pop up a calculator. So now let's see if it works or not. Good, so everything works.